Hello everyone and welcome back to White Pen Racing. Today we'll talk about straight and helical toothed gears, pros and cons. So, in the meantime, a general premise. In both car and motorcycle transmissions, there are straight teeth and helical teeth used in various ways. So what's the difference? The helical tooth, so-called constant mesh, has the advantage of being essentially silent. This is the main advantage. It's silent because by being always in grip, there isn't that succession of bumps that over a certain speed turns into a whistle. It has different tones depending on the frequency. Let's look at an evident case and probably known to those who are a little advanced in years like me, considering they make the straight teeth quite well today, so they whistle less. Do you remember the typical whistle of illegal Vespas when we were 15, 16, 18? The ones with the so-called bell of the 90, which was a 2472 with straight teeth. They whistled at a lower pitch than 2769 or 2968 mounted, simply because eventually the peripheral speed of the drive gear was slower, thus spinning faster. And spinning faster, the bump sequence was also faster with a bigger gear. So with a smaller one, it runs slower, slower bump sequence and lower pitch. Now, the gears have been improved, so they whistle less, but much, much less. Some won't whistle at all if the distance is right, if the bearings are in place and if everything is working properly and there are no excessive games. In some cases, so you won't even hear it. Therefore, the choice of using helical or straight tooth gears concerns the high speed transmission, essentially the primary one to overcome the noise problem. Slowly spinning gears do not whistle. In the Vespa gearbox, there are straight tooth gears that cannot be heard turning as long as they are intact. The primary whistles because it runs faster. So cars have helical gearboxes, except for reverse in most cases. Very old cars also had the first gear, sometimes even the second gear, with straight teeth, and in fact they used to sing a little, but in cars the gearbox is a primary transmission because the secondary reduction is on the differential, so the gear turns fast in the case of the car at the speed of the crankshaft, then with more or less long ratios. Now, what's the advantage of the helical tooth? The disadvantage of the helical tooth is that it absorbs a greater share of power, because not only the motion will be transmitted, but there will be in the reaction to traction, there'll be a thrust. An axial thrust. So not only the center of the two gears will tend to move away, so the bearings will not be loaded only in the radial direction to open, but also actually, that is, the teeth will tend to escape one on the other sideways, going to load the bearings. In a way for which they may not be particularly suited to work, even if the effort is clearly foreseen, but it is foreseen in the case of our beloved motor scooters of a certain power. Not so much anymore. In particular, what suffer in the case of Vespas is the transmission bearing on which the primary rotates. Moreover, it is a bearing that Piaggio has progressively enlarged at least three times, if I recall correctly, because already on the engines at 2% three times, because of the VNB, even VBB, there was a small bearing, very small, very, very small. Then on TS, GTR, Sprint Veloce, and the first PX with small tooth gearbox, a slightly bigger bearing, and then even a bigger one they put it on the 200 engine, already on the 180 on the 180 rally, where there is a big tooth gearbox and the bearing was as big as the 200. So it's a weak element in the transmission chain, and this bearing with elaborate motors suffers a lot from the axle load caused by the helical teeth. Basically, and now I'm a bit biased maybe, but I don't like the helical teeth so much on the primaries. If it's possible to use the straight ones, it's always better. It can certainly be useless on low-powered engines, on the original 125-150, but even on the original 200, in the end, the primary is fine. However, if we are talking about more pushing engines, in any case, more powerful engines, the straight tooth is certainly better. Not much whistling left too, I must say. They whistle very little compared to what happened in the past, and the load to which the bearings are subjected is only radial. On the large Vespas, there is also another drawback, which many of you may be aware of, because I'm sure that, especially with commercial 8-spring clutches, on more than one, the elastic stop came off, and the clutch got opened, and the Vespa stopped. Even in the lucky case that bits and stuff didn't end up where they shouldn't have. So why does it happen? Due to the axle load, which reverses the direction according to whether the motor is pulling or releasing. You will have noticed that when you turn on the throttle, the flywheel comes out, the fan cover gets a little damage, and the fan tends to understand it. It tends to rub on the fan cover, while instead, when the engine is in release and is dragged from the wheel, the flywheel retracts and the clutch. The flywheel retracts and the clutch plays noticeable on the lower drop. Because the crankshaft, thanks to the clutch side bearing play, which is the one that constrains the axis in the axle direction, moves and presses, so to speak, and the clutch just covers it. So it gets closer, so the lever travel is reduced. Now, what happens? In those commercial 8-spring clutches, the original curl has the right size. There are several commercial curls circulating that are just longer. They have made a measure like this, probably. It seems safe. However, it happens that in pull release, this variation of play is very sensitive, and even if it is apparently little thing, I mean, that jerk on the engine, it tends to make the annular stop come out, especially the original one. Those DRT are supplied with this SIP belt, which are big, maybe not, even if they are often moved, but the original ones come out. So a small practical example, so we understand each other better, even if we will then maybe make a video about the clutches. So the play I was referring to, this here, as you can see, is a hub of the 8-spring clutch. Its primary gears is this, so there it is, you see it? The curl is a little too high. It has its shim already like this, so how can you fix it? Either you lathe bake back here to reduce the play by a couple of tenths, in short, the one that allows you to tighten it without blocking it, but which prevents this annoying axle deviation. But beware that if you turn it, it must be turned straight, because if you go wrong, then it's a big problem. It'll rest badly. Or you take either a shaving of the old PX and put it under, or another one of these. You cut the edge and then you make a washer to put under this one, so that the play is reduced. Then it rests on a plane, turns freely, without having this actual play resolved. All this reasoning is valid only if you want or have to use helical teeth, because with straight teeth, there is absolutely no point in removing this play, because there will be no axle thrusts, and it is verifiable by touching the clutch lever, the play which will remain unchanged with the engine in pull release. If you like this video, leave a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Remember,
White Pen Racing is not a workshop, but an amateur sport association that works on engines only for sport purposes and only for its associates.